Hey you guys, this is Dev. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Design a Scenario. Well, last time we were doing this beautiful map. I have made a couple of changes to it, as you can see. But for this episode's sake, we'll mainly be talking about triggers. So I have made a couple of not so important changes. First of all, I'm gonna explain what we'll be doing. There are going to be four different factions, so to speak. And each faction is gonna have like a team, and each wave there's gonna be all these teams fighting in the arena. And we'll of course be able to choose a class from each of these teams. For now we have Rangers, Warriors, Rogues and Beasts. They'll all have different attributes and abilities, and yeah, it should be a lot of fun. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna make some sort of opening cutscene. First of all, we're gonna play around with map revealers. Map revealers are objects that will reveal a certain part of the map. So even if you don't have unit there, you can see what's going on. So we go to units, we go to other, and select map revealer. Now, we can't see it right now because it's invisible, and it will always be invisible. But if we press Ctrl and A, we can see the outlines of every single unit here. These cliffs have outlines, this unit, every single thing we place will have an outline, including map revealer. So let's place one. Like right here. Yeah, that'll do. And let's see what we can see. As you can see, even if I don't have a unit here, we will be able to see what's going on here. So we want this whole arena to be sort of revealed, but we don't want these big spaces here revealed. So let's play some more. So let's play some. I'm gonna place one in the middle, obviously. And we're gonna go like this way, some this way. About right, a few more down here. And that's about right. So let's remove the unnecessary ones, like this one. I like to keep things steady, so yeah. So let's just copy this bit right here. Seems about right. So let's make some sort of intro cutscene. As you can see, every time we test the game, these four players are getting defeated because they have no units on screen. No units placed for them and no room to spawn a town center, so they're getting defeated. So what we want to do there is we want to create a hold of unit for each of these, as well for ourselves, because in a cutscene we sometimes don't want a unit of ours on the screen. So we're gonna remove this one, and as we start the game we're obviously gonna get defeated. So what we wanna do is we're gonna select player 2. So player 2 is the one who owns all the buildings, so he's an ally to us. We're gonna place down a battering ram about, let's say, right here. First of all, let's disable all these outlines. I'm gonna press Ctrl and A again. However, now there is a problem. If we select a unit in here or in the game, we will not see the outline or the health bar. And this will stay like this until the game is restarted. Unfortunately, there is currently no fix for this, so let's just quickly restart the game. And here we are. So we were talking about hold of units. So what we're gonna do is, so this player 2 has now a battering ram. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna place a unit of ours, a militia simply, right next to it. About, let's enable off-grid placement with Control S. Now let's place it a little bit closer, right there. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna make a new trigger, or we already have a trigger here, but we're gonna make a new one just for this one, and we're gonna call it hold off units. It's not gonna need a condition, it's simply gonna have an effect, which is a task object effect right here. We're gonna set object our militia. We're gonna set the location to be this battering ram. So since this battering ram is our ally, we're going to garrison this militia into it. If it was our enemy, the militia would attack the battering ram. If it was an object where we couldn't garrison anything inside, then it would simply walk towards it. So that's very nice. So, and after that we're gonna have a task object, the same trigger, which is going to task this battering ram somewhere out of the way, up here. There. So let's see what happens. As you can see, our unit is now garrisoned inside and the ram is moving this way. However, since this ram is quite slow, first let me demonstrate what happens when the ram moves off screen. We cannot select the unit or anything, we can press the comma button to quickly jump to it, but we won't be able to ungarrison it. So it's now as if we don't have any unit, but we still can view the game and all. So let's do that for the other players as well. Let's make the triggers, hold off units, let's task them inside the ram. So as you can see, what I'm doing, I set the object to be the militia, and I set the location to be the battering ram. Since this ram is allied to all of these other players as well, so they are not going to attack it, they're just going to garrison inside it. I'm not sure, however, how many space there is in this ram, if all units are gonna fit inside it, so let's just try it out. Ah, apparently there was not enough space. So we're just gonna find a way around this one guy. We're just gonna make a second ram. Yeah, that's right, a second ram, a battering ram. Right here. And we're gonna change our unit to go into this other one. And we're gonna add a new task object to task this other ram to that same location. So in case you have no idea what I'm doing, these triggers will fire the moment the game starts because they have no condition and their starting state is set to on. If they had a condition, for example, like, let's just add one real quick, like a timer of 30, then all these effects would not fire until 30 in-game seconds have passed. And we have lots of other effects we can add and other conditions. But yeah, we don't need a condition right now because this is supposed to happen at the very start of the game. So what we're also gonna do, we're gonna add a couple of new effects to change object speed. We scroll all the way down, we have change speed, change range, change armor and all this stuff. These effects are not available in the vanilla Age of Empires 2, in the CD version. So to get that, you will have to download the user patch. A link to that will be in the description. However, if you have the HD version of Age of Empires 2, no need to worry, these effects are right there. So let's change the speed. One thing to note though is the effects are called change speed and change name, change HP, change attack, but they're actually adding whatever we type in here. So let's make this 100. No, let's make this 500. 500 right here. Let's do the same for the other one. So it's not changing the unit speed to 500, it's adding 500 to the existing speed. Let's do the same for this one. 500. And let's test it. This guy was still kinda left behind, but as you could see, these ramps now moved there very quickly, and we're not gonna hear from them again. So let's try to find out why this red guy is not willing to enter the ramp. Yes, that's it was apparently not selected properly. Alright, so what we wanna do next is we're gonna create some sort of intro cutscene. So we want the camera to start right here in the dark, then it's smoothly going to move up here into the arena as we have three different units walking onto these piles, onto these little hills. So for that we're first going to set the starting view. What this does is we're going to go to options and we're going to scroll all the way down here and we're going to click set view. Make sure the player one is selected, we're going to do set view. So whatever happens now, you can go to views, yeah, it's right here. The view will start, the scenario will start with the camera right here, no matter what happens. So we're gonna add a couple of triggers. We're gonna add a new one right here. We're gonna call it cutscene 1. Now pay attention to these little settings right here. We have displays objective, which is not important right now. We have trigger starting state, which is important. We're gonna leave this on for now, but in future triggers we're gonna turn it off. What this does is, if it's on, the trigger will fire right away. If it's off, however, it will not happen, even if the condition is fulfilled. So if it's on, the game will check right away if the condition is fulfilled. Right now let's just make it a timer of 2 seconds. So right as the game starts, this timer will start ticking, 2 seconds simply, and then we're going to add a new effect, which is called change view. I'm gonna change the view somewhere right there. Click go to location. If you ever press go to location and the camera does not move, then something is wrong. The trigger will most likely stay red until it's fixed. Sometimes it can just bug out. In that case, just restart your game and set the trigger again. So we're gonna add another one called cutscene 2. In this case we're gonna want the starting state to turn off. Why? Because we're gonna do this the exact same the other one just did, with a timer of 2 and a change view, this time a little bit further, like right here. So why is this one off? Because it will not happen, we don't want it to happen. Hang on, let's make that 2. We don't want this timer to start ticking until this trigger has done everything it needs to do. To do this, we're gonna do activate trigger. We're gonna select cutscene 1, which is on by default. We're gonna make a new trigger, which is called activate trigger. This one is going to select cutscene 2. So once the timer of cutscene 1 has completed ticking, it will activate the timer of cutscene 2. So it can start ticking. We could of course just leave all this and make this a timer of 4 and 6 and 8, but if you make longer cutscenes this is gonna get quite difficult later. So this is how I always do it. We've got this one right here. Let's do this another time. Alright, now that that's done, let's see how this works. So we start down here, the camera moves this way, we don't see a tiny trace of the RAM. So That's pretty perfect. What we're gonna do next, we're gonna have three different units walking out of these entrances. We're gonna have, and that's how we're gonna select the classes. So the three classes are Ranger, which is an archer. It's gonna be a plumed archer. And it's gonna come out of the blue hole. Well, let's make that player two. A plumed archer.
Yeah.
Right here. The next one is gonna be the warrior, which is golden. And that's gonna be a berserk. He's a slow but heavy kind of armor type of guy.
Yeah.
Of course, you might wonder, the berserk is running pretty fast. Faster than most units, as is the plumed archer. But we're, as you saw with the ram, we're gonna use the change object speed to make this berserk much slower than it actually is. So it really feels like a heavy armor kind of guy. And the third class is going to be the rogue, which is gonna be a slow, or no, a fast actually, fast Teutonic Knight. Let's place that right here.
Yeah.
So, what we're gonna do, we've got these settings right here. We're gonna just add a couple of new effects. This one is gonna be called Change Object Name. We're gonna change them accordingly. This one is gonna be Ranger, set object, go to object to see if it's properly selected. As I said, if the camera doesn't move, then something went wrong, then you gotta do it again. Let's do the same for the other two. Rogue. Now we're gonna change the speed as well. Let's go right down here. Set object.
Yeah.
This berserk, we're gonna give him, gonna remove the zero, and we're gonna type minus 25. So now he's 25 something slower. Oh, we just deleted that. Let's place it again. Speed, select this guy. Minus 25. Let's do the same for the other two. The ranger, the plumed archer, is also quite fast. This one is gonna get minus 10. And the rogue, on the other hand, is some sort of assassin. So he's gonna get increased speed. Because Teutonic Knights are pretty slow by default. So let's increase this one by 25. And now we're gonna edit cutscene 1. As this trigger starts, we're gonna have these three guys walk right onto the center. If you're asking about this lower one, this is only where animals are gonna come out of. So if there's gonna be like wolves, a wave of wolves, or jaguars or something, that's where this is gonna come out. So no class for this one, just nothing right now. So we've got this new effect in cutscene 1. That's gonna be a task object. It's gonna set this guy to walk right onto this. Oh, that's wrong. Let's set the location again. Right there. Go to location and camera moves. It's properly set. Let's do the same for the other two guys. All three of them. Perfect. So what we want to do now is we want to have a text appearing that says something like select your class. So let's add that. We can do that directly. So to add a text that says select your class, we want to have a, in cutscene 4, although, yeah, we're going to have a new trigger that we're just going to call it text class select. Gonna be off, and just like all those cutscene triggers, it's gonna be activated by the most recent trigger. Let's make a new effect, activate trigger, select text class select. Well, we're just gonna call it text class for now. It's gonna be in a timer, obviously. If we had it happen instantly without a timer or any condition, we could just put the same effect in the previous trigger. It would have the same outcome. So let's make the timer 3 seconds. And to make a text appear, we're gonna have to use the display instructions trigger effect. I keep saying trigger, but it's the effect. So we're gonna have it appear for 30 seconds. So we change the timer here up here to 30. The message itself is gonna be so what's gonna happen is these three guys are standing here. We're gonna select one of them and then his ownership changes to us. If we select another one, the previous one is gonna be changed back to player 2 and the one we just selected is gonna be converted to us. To select the class as I just described down here, we're gonna simply have to our unit kill the other two. It's gonna happen real quick and probably one hit because it's not a real fight yet, but there's one more thing left to do in this effect. We have a number here. It's gonna be 0, 1, or 2. What this does is it defines how high or low the text is gonna be. So if it's 0, it's gonna be all the way on top. If it's 2, it's gonna be somewhat in the middle. Not in the middle, but kind of like a third into the screen. So we wanna have it, we don't wanna have it all the way on top, so let's have it on number 2. Now we're gonna have two display instructions triggers. We're gonna have make another one, which is gonna be 0, so all the way on top, and it's gonna be like timer of 50. And it's gonna be 500, so it's gonna stay up there for a while. However, we can remove it. I'm gonna show you that later. So right now we're just gonna have welcome to the arena. Please select your class, click the units to get information on the class. To choose your class, simply kill the other two units. So now we're gonna do this. When you select the unit, it's gonna turn, it's gonna change ownership to you. It's gonna be converted to you, so to speak. So let's just make a new trigger. Trigger 7, we're also gonna make this off. Gonna do select warrior. We'll make another one, select ranger. This one is also going to be off, and select rogue. This one is going to be off as well. The text trigger is gonna activate all three of them, so let's add an activate trigger effect. Select warrior, select ranger, and select rogue. So we do this to make sure if these are starting on, then we don't obviously won't need the activate triggers, but if we do that, then we can already select them before the text appears. We can just select them from the start on and it will happen, but we don't want that. We only want the player to be able to select them once this text tells us to. So let's make the conditions. This condition is going to be object selected. Simply you can set the object. This one is the warrior, so we set this object, make sure it's go to object, camera moves, perfect, and it's gonna have an effect, change ownership of this object. Then we're gonna have to set the target player down here to player 2. All these other options we don't need to touch them, just target player, player 1 obviously. So now, whoever this one belongs to, when we select it, it will be converted to us instantly. We're gonna do the same for the other two. So now, if we select, let's select this guy. And now he belongs to us. Select this guy and he belongs to us. Now we obviously have the problem, if we select all three of them, they all three belong to us. So we want to, if we select another one, the other two are also going to be changed back to player 2. So just in case we already selected one of them, that all the other ones are going to be changed back. So, and we also want want us to be able to select them multiple times. So say I select the ranger now, then I select this guy, then the ranger is going to be changed back. But maybe I do change my mind and I do want the ranger after all, so the trigger will have to be activated again. So let's do that. So we're going to do select warrior, and we're also going to do change ownership of this guy to player 2, in case he doesn't belong to player 2. I'm going to do the same for the rogue, right here, player 2, and let's do the same for the other two guys. Now we're also going to add an activate trigger to each of these. So if you select the warrior, it's going to activate ranger, and it's going to activate rogue. So just in case we already selected rogue or ranger, all of these triggers can only happen once, unless we make it looping. That's a whole different thing. So in case we select the warrior and we had already selected the ranger, we would not be able to select them again. However, because of this activate trigger, because this trigger activates ranger again, we will be able to select them a second time. And same goes for the rogue. We're gonna do the same for these other two. Right, it happened a bit early, but it's about okay. So we select this one, now move him around. Now we select this guy, and this guy does no longer belong to us. Same goes for this guy. And if we had not included the activate triggers, the activate trigger effects, then we would not be able to select this guy a second time, or this guy a second time. Could only do it ever once, and yeah, if we want to change our mind, we couldn't do that. But yeah, so that works. And only have one of them at a time. A couple of things we want to do actually is we're just gonna add a couple of triggers to these settings. That's gonna be freeze unit. What this does, it changes the unit stance to non-attack. So why am I doing this? Because once we select a unit, the other two guys are gonna be made enemies there. Their ownership is going to be changed to enemies. However, we don't want them to attack us, we only want to be able to attack them, just so we can choose our class, so to speak. So if we freeze them, it literally means they will not attack anyone or anything. So let's do that for all three of them for now. Of course, we can task them to attack another object, but only if we decide to do so. We won't. All three of them, nice. So what we want to do now is we're also going to change their ownership right away. We change the ownership of this guy to, hang on, player 4 is warriors, player 5 is rangers. Okay, we're going to do this right away so they appear in the correct color as well. Change ownership of this guy to player 5, that's rangers. Change the ownership of this guy to player 4, which is warriors. And change the ownership of this guy to player 6, which is rangers. Of course, we could just delete these units and place them for the other players. However, if we do this now, then all the triggers that we used on them will be broken. Because we would just have to reselect them again, because it's technically a different object if we delete it, place it again. So we don't want to go through that trouble, so let's just do that. So we're also gonna adjust these to change the ownership of the other two guys to the according player, that's player 5. It seems, apparently these guys were not right for some reason. But as you can see, you can now attack these two dudes. And I also have the proper color. So apparently they weren't the right color at the beginning of the game, so let's see what's up with that. So another thing we wanna do is, as we select a unit, we wanna have a bit of information on them. So we're gonna make a display instruction trigger, this time on number 2, which is the lowest. And this one is just gonna be for 20 seconds. And it's gonna be, if you select the warrior, it's gonna be in yellow. It's gonna be heavily armored warrior. Slow, but regenerates health. So as we select the ranger, we're obviously gonna have a couple of lines describing him on number 2, because if you do it on number 1, then one of those other texts will go that are on that number are gonna go away. So let's make that 30 seconds. Alright, that's a that's probably a difficult thing to make, but we'll make it, because this guy is gonna need some sort of special thing. So the berserk can regenerate, this guy is ranged, and this guy needs some sort of special power. So yeah, he's gonna be able to destroy the trees and hurt the enemies around them. So let's see how that works. So we select, let's select this guy, and now we get a little line down here describing him. We select this guy, we get a line describing him. We select this guy, we get a line describing him. About perfect, we can kill them. Now there's two more things left to do to finish this. We're obviously gonna have to detect when one of the guys kills the other two, then that means that we selected this class. And another thing we wanna do is, if we task them all the way around, as we select another one, we want them to return to their original location. So to do that, we're simply gonna add a couple of things. As we select the warrior, the other two guys are gonna return to their location, if they left it, of course. So we're gonna make a task object, the ranger, which is not the one we selected. Gonna be tasked this way, and the rogue is gonna be tasked right here. If you select the ranger, so let's select this guy, you know, own him. So now if you select this rogue guy, these two are just going to be tasked back to their own location. So let's try that. You can see this guy returns to where he was. Same goes for all the other ones. Let's do this one. However, as it seems, so apparently something was wrong with the object selected condition. So we've deleted that and fixed that, so we're getting information as we select them. Select the rogue, we get quick and deadly assassin, can use magic to bring down trees and harm enemies. Select the warrior, heavily armored warrior, slow but regenerates health. And now there's just two more things to do and we've got the class selection finished. We want to change their statistics accordingly. As you can probably tell, the Archer is still a little bit slower than the... Although that's alright. We're gonna have to change their stats. So the Art Ranger has 5 attack, 50 health, that's okay. We want the Rogue to have a little bit... we want the Rogue to have a little bit less health than the other guys. His attack is quite okay. This guy's attack is also okay. So, we're just gonna have to change the health of the Rogue and the Warrior. The Rogue, we want him to have 40 health. We want the Warrior to have 70. Yeah. 40 and 70. So, let's just change it real quick. Triggers. We're just gonna do this in the settings. We're gonna make a new effect. Change object hit points. As I said earlier, these don't change the hit points, they add the hit points. So we're gonna add 12, we're gonna add 22 to give this guy 70. And we're gonna do the same for this guy who has 70, but we're gonna change it to, gonna make this minus 30, so he has 40. So now that that's done, there's one more thing to do, and that's where we're gonna detect whether there was some sort of, whether the other two guys are killed. So if you're the Warrior, we want to detect if these two guys are killed. So for that we're going to make a new trigger. Okay, we're going to do the name this Chose Warrior. It's going to be off, obviously. Though this one can actually stay on, because whatever happens, it's not going to happen anyways before we own a unit. So what we're going to do is, we're going to give this one two conditions. Destroy object. Destroy object this guy. So this means that whatever happens will not happen until this guy is dead. Or removed for some reason. So we're gonna have we're gonna remove this effect. We're gonna add the second condition. Destroy object this guy. So if these two guys are killed, then obviously this one is the only one left, so we choose this guy. So we're gonna make an effect. We're gonna clear instructions. So we have clear instructions right here, so here we can simply enter a number. 0 on top, 1 in the middle, and 2 kind of 1/3. So what this does, it simply removes whatever is written there, and so yeah, we're gonna clear 0, and we're gonna clear 2. The other hand, we're gonna make display instructions on number 1. Let's make that 20 seconds. Let's make that yellow. I have chosen the Warrior. Let the slaughter begin. Nice, let's do the same for the other two guys. Let's save it and test it. Right, welcome to the arena. Please select your class, click the units to get information on the class to choose your class. Simply kill the other two units. Right, let's choose the Warrior. Let's walk around with him. I don't think I like him. I'm gonna try this guy. This guy is quite cool, I think, so let's kill the other two. Although, no, I don't really care. As you can see, so he tried to select the other guy. This one is gonna stop what he's doing, and Of course, now that we can't select this guy anymore, but we can change our mind and choose the warrior instead. And just kill this guy. Or vice versa. We chose the rogue, let the slaughter begin. So now that we've successfully done a class selection, we're gonna end this video right here. I think I've been going on long enough. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time with the waves of enemies and the fighting in the arena and general awesomeness. So if you like this, subscribe so you won't miss your next episode, and feel free to leave suggestions or comments or likes. If you like the video, like it, obviously. And yeah, I'm happy about any comments, suggestions, criticism, anything. Leave it down below. See you guys.